have loved reading from my very childhood. My own personal library consisted of 150,000 rare books of all the religions, philosophies, poetry, literature, and I have read all of them, but with no purpose. I enjoyed it. My father used to go at least 3-4 times to Bombay, and he will ask all the children what he would like, and he will ask me also that if you want anything, so I can note it down and I can bring from Bombay. I never asked him. I said, I only want you come back more human, less fatherly, more friendly. Less dictatorial, more democratic. Bring a little more freedom for me when you come back. He will say, but these things are not available in the market. I said, I know they are not available in the market, but these are the things that I would like, a little more freedom. A little bigger rope. Less orders, less commandments. And a little respect. No child has asked for respect. You ask for toys, sweets, clothes, a bicycle, and things like that, you get them. But these are not the real things which are going to make your life blissful. I asked him money only when I wanted to purchase more books. I never asked money for anything else. And I told him that when I ask for books, you better give me. He said, what do you mean? I said, I simply mean that if you don't give me, then I will have to steal it. I don't want to be a thief, but if you force me, then there is no way. I don't have money, you know. I need these books and I am going to have them, that you know. So if money is not given to me, then I will take it. And remember in your mind that it was you who forced me to steal. He said, no need to steal. Whenever you need money, you simply come and take. And I said, you be assured it is only for the books. And there was no need to be assurance because he went on seeing my library growing in the house. Slowly there was no place in the house for anything else than my books. And my father said, now, first in our house we had a library. Now, in the library, we have a house. And your books, we all have to take care of them, because if something goes wrong with any book, you make so much fuss. You create so much trouble that everybody is afraid of your books, and they are everywhere. You cannot avoid stumbling on them. And there are small children. I said, small children are not a problem to me. The problem are the older children. Because the smaller children, I respect them so much that they are very protective of my books. It was a strange thing to see in my house. My younger brothers and sisters were all protective of my books when I was not there. Nobody could touch my books. And they will clean them and they will keep them in the right place, wherever I have put them. So when I need any book, I can find it. And it was a simple matter because I was so respectful to them. They could not show their respect in any other way than to be respectful to my books. I said, the real problem are the older children. My uncles, my aunts, my father's sisters, these are the people, my father's brother-in-laws, these are the people who are trouble. Because I don't want anybody else to mark on my books, underline on my books. I hated the very idea that somebody should underline on my book. One of my father's brother-in-law was a professor, so must have been in habit of write notes on my books. I had to tell him that this is simply not only unmannerly, uncivilized, it shows what kind of mind you have. To me, book is not just a book, it is a love affair. And if you underline any book, then you have to pay for it and you take the book, because then I don't want that book here. Because one dirty fist can make the whole pond dirty. I don't want any book prostituted, you take it. He was very angry because he could not understand. I said, you don't understand me because you don't know me much. You just talk to my father. And my father said to him that it was your fault. Why you underlined his book? Why you wrote a note on his book? What purpose it serves to you? Because the book will remain in his library. In the first place, you never asked his permission that you want to read his book. You will be surprised that by the time I was matriculate, I had read thousands of books. I was finished with Khalil Gibran, Dostoevsky, Tolstoy, Chekhov, Gorky, Turgenev. When I was finishing my intermediate, I was finished with Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, Bertrand Russell, all philosophers that I could find in any library, in any bookshop, from anybody to borrow.
Why did you stop reading in 1980, and how do you stay informed on worldly events? I've heard that you enjoy movies and watch movies at times. Is that true?
Once in a while, because I don't read anymore. Otherwise, I was perhaps the most educated man in the whole world. My own personal library was 150,000 volumes of immense value. And I was reading continuously. But then I got my own truth. And all those books started seeming rubbish. Slowly, they became meaningless. Once in a while, one book may turn out to have some significance. But 5 years before, I stopped it. It was too much. You read 100 books, and one book sometimes turns out to be of any meaning. And that too is not going to increase my consciousness, my being. So for 5 years I have not read anything, no newspaper, no radio, no television. Once in a while, if my sannyasins see a film which they feel has something significant, then I see it. But very rarely. For example, Dostoevsky's Brothers Karamazov, when it became a film, then I saw it, because I consider that book to be far more valuable than Holy Bible. It is so immensely rich with insights. So it happens once in a while that they bring something. If they feel that it may interest me, then I see it, but rarely.